If you're new to virtual machines or just curious about them, in this tutorial I'm going to show you what a virtual box is, how to install one, configure an OS, and how to use it. So stick around. Welcome back everyone, I'm Daniel, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you specifically a virtual box by Oracle. There's many different ones out there. But first off, to try and get an understanding of what exactly is a virtual box. A virtual box or a virtual machine is simply a simulation of a computer that's all software based inside your existing computer. So if you wanted to test something out or play around with something without taking a risk of getting a virus or destroying your computer, and you don't want to get another second physical computer to play with, you can create this other second computer inside of your existing computer. So anything that you do inside of that virtual computer is completely isolated and separate from the computer that you're physically on. I'm going to be installing this to make my next video on that. If you look at the video that comes out after this one, I'm going to be doing that using this virtual box. So if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do and stay tuned for my next upcoming video. So let's jump on my computer and have a look at how to install one. So we're on virtualbox.org and there's a convenient button that's so massive right here to download VirtualBox 6.1 is the version as of the shooting of this video. So let's click on that and it takes us to another page. So it looked a little too good to be true to just click a button and it downloads, but instead it's given us a whole bunch of options here. Looking at the binaries and platform packages, we want to go down to the VirtualBox platform packages and choose Windows, because we're on Windows unless you're on a Mac or Linux or one of these other platforms. And then we're prompted to download the actual installer file. So now that it's downloaded, I got the installer here I'm running, so we'll just follow through. Next gives you a few options here. You can click on each one of them and it gives you a description about it over to the right. So if you wanted to read a little bit more about these things, you can, but if you're not sure about any of it, you can just leave the defaults and hit next. In a case where you want to change the location of where it's stored, if you want to keep the space free on your computer, especially for the packages of where things are going to be installed, you can change that by going to Browse. And I'll simply just change the drive letter from C to D and hit OK. So it's going to go on my D drive and I'm going to hit Next. In your case, it's up to you where you want that to be installed. You have the options of having start menu items, shortcut on the desktop, and the quick launch and registering file associations. It's good to have the file associations so it knows how to work with them, and definitely have it in the start menu, but it's up to you whether or not you want a shortcut on your desktop and a quick launch. I really don't want it in the quick launch, but I'll keep it on the desktop for now and I may take it out from there later. Next, this does have a warning that it's going to temporarily disconnect your internet and network connection because it's a virtual machine and it has to set up the network configuration to work through there because it uses your physical hardware to work with their interface. So that's fine. As long as you're not in the middle of something where it's going to cut out your internet, then you're okay to proceed now. And then just a final check to make sure that you're ready to install. We'll hit install. Let it run through and it should be done fairly quickly. If you're prompted for an alert, you'll have to hit yes. And it's done installing. So now we're able to open it and it gives us the option to open it immediately once we hit finish. Now that we have the VirtualBox software installed, we don't actually have a VirtualBox on our machine yet. We just have the software that gives us the ability to create virtual boxes or virtual machines or virtual systems. Depending on the terminology you want to use, it's all meaning the same thing. So let's go and set up our first operating system. So the first thing you're going to need is a operating system. So it can be any machine. I'm going to go and get the Windows 10. So now that I got the Windows 10 toolkit, I'm able to create a ISO file, which is what we need here, using the recommended for this PC, because it's this PC's hardware that we're using, and I want an ISO file. So I'm going to save that, wait for that to download, and then we'll be able to use that to install our virtual machine inside the VirtualBox software. Now that we got our ISO file, we can import this into the software. So from here, we can do a bunch of different things. There's preferences in here that will allow you to change the general preferences of things such as your default machine folder, which we've already got set up in D, so it knows to use that as the default location for all the operating systems that we're going to do. If you had something to import from, you could do that, or you can even export your current setup. You've got the new operating system that we're going to set up, and then you can also add additional virtual machines, but that's getting way beyond the scope of this basic tutorial. So we just want to go straight into adding a new operating system. So we're going to give it a name. Since this is a Windows 10 install, we're going to call it Windows 10, and it's Pro Edition, so we might as well be very specific about that, in exactly which operating system type it is. So we know it's the Pro and 64-bit that I'm going to be doing, and it even says here it's assuming by default we're going to use Windows and Windows 10 64-bit. So we'll hit next, and we can allocate how much memory do we want to use in this. So you've got out of the maximum amount of memory that you have in your system, but it shows in red here for a reason, because you don't want to max it out and use all of your system resources to use the virtual machine. So they're recommending 2 gigs, but I'm finding that maybe that's not going to be very much for me, so I'm going to put it at about 4. We'll go next here. You have the option of creating a virtual disk. You can say you don't want to add one at all yet, or create a virtual disk now, or use an existing hard disk file. Well, we don't have an existing one yet, and we don't really want to exclude one. We want to have something that we can work with for adding files. So we'll just leave that to create a virtual one now. And then it gives you a few different options on how you would like to create this virtual disk. So for the most part, you may be fine to just leave the default on. Also, the storage, for how it works, it can be dynamically allocated if you're not sure how big you're going to need it, and it'll increase and decrease. It'll increase the size of the disk as needed, but as it says here, it will not decrease later automatically, which is fine, because if you hit a fixed disk, it's going to create it at a fixed size whether you need that much or not. And if you needed more afterwards, you're going to be kind of stuck with that. So I would recommend leaving it as dynamically allocated. And we'll go next. And with how big do we want to have this set at? Since I have this on a drive that I know I've got the extra storage space, I'm going to leave it as the default of 50 gigs. And we now have our system showing here. It's got all the system configuration settings showing in here of how much memory do we have, the type of display, the storage, our audio, the network, our USB connections, and so on. So it can share this same hardware, which is why it gave us the option of choosing how much memory did we want to allocate to this, because it's sharing our system resources and we're using our physical machine to run this virtual machine. Now that we've got this virtual machine set up, let's use it. So we'll hit the start button up here, and this begins the initial setup. So since there's nothing installed, we need to select a startup disk. I've got these Linux ISOs from previously, but I don't have the Windows one showing in here, so I'm going to click this little button here. I'm going to go into add and find the Windows ISO that I just downloaded earlier. So that's in here. We're going to choose that. And we're going to start booting from that. If we look over here to the side here in the VirtualBox manager, we're able to see that the Windows 10 Pro virtual machine is currently running. Although it's not running Windows, it's running the installation process. So the machine is running, but we don't have an OS yet. So we just booted from an ISO image. So it's like booting from a CD or a USB stick. So we're able to go through the installation process just as we would with a USB or a CD. So I'm going to run through this installation and reconnect with you here again once it's done, so you don't have to sit there and watch me do the install. One of the things that you'll see is after you've reviewed the alerts here, you may find that if you hit the X on these things that they just keep reappearing. If you don't want to keep seeing this message every time, you can hit the little bubble over here and it will hide it and not show you that message again. Once the operating system is completely installed, you can use it just as you do any other computer, just like your own. You got your start button there that you can click on with all your menu items. Everything is exactly the same. You even have your network access showing down there with the date, time, and everything is just like a fresh install. All we would do here now is go to X out of it up in the top right corner. So we'll be prompted with three options for shutting off the computer. And the first option here is to save the machine state, which is kind of like putting it to sleep. The second option here is to send the shutdown signal, which is the clean recommended way of powering off the computer. It's like clicking the start button and saying shut down on your computer. And the third option is basically forcing the computer off and it crashes it, so it has no way of gracefully saving any information to shut down properly. So we'll go to send the shutdown signal and we'll hit OK. So you can see that the Windows 10 is installed and it's in the powered off state. So with that highlighted, we would just click the start button. And it will begin loading the Windows 10 virtual machine. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you guys did find it helpful. And if you did, please do hit that like button. Consider subscribing and ring the bell to be notified every time we come out with a new video, premiere, or live stream. All right. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.